The Naples Sabot has been sailed in Southern California between San Diego and Long Beach for generations. There's a good chance your parents and grandparents all raced Sabots. Over the years, the Sabot has produced countless national champions, world champions, and Olympians. We're going to take a look back in time to the summer of 2003. Your eyes open, you might see some world champions and a two-time Olympian. Oh yeah, there's a few college All-Americans and college Sailor of the Year. Sabot sailors, and thanks for joining us. First up, sailing upwind. The Sabot is highly adjustable. Your mast rig, traveler, outhaul, downhaul, and boom bang all have to be in the right spot. This boat here has a light to medium air mast rig setting. Notice the boom is roughly 15 inches off the transom of the boat. In lighter wind than this, you'd want to move the mast rake further back, maybe one hole, to get that boom lower. In breezy conditions, you'd want to move this mast rake further forward, get that boom higher, maybe move it forward one hole. This traveler is set for light to medium conditions. Notice it's set between the rudder and the corner of the boat, approximately halfway in between. It's a good spot. Notice the sheeting angle. Drop your traveler all the way down in heavier wind. To adjust your outhaul, make sure your foot is approximately 4 to 6 inches from the center of your boom. Try not to use your downhaul light wind. Medium breezes, 75% of the wrinkles out. Heavy wind, pull all the wrinkles out. Upwind tips. Avoid unnecessary movement. Remember, all movement affects the boat. Less steering the better. Your rudder is a brake. Don't use it too much. No windward heel. Sailing over flat upwind really hurts your boat speed. Avoid pinching. Another way to stall your boat. Keep way forward. Boat's got a lot of rocker in it. You sit too far back, you drag the stern. You gotta be up against your flotation tank. Don't over trim. You'll get over bend wrinkles in the sail. Pull on your sail too tight, bends the mast too much. Get these diagonal creases. Watch for puffs ahead. Good sailors always looking for puffs, anticipating them, not wasting them. Watch your telltales. Try not to take your eyes off them. You don't want to miss lifts. Play your downhaul often in light to medium breezes. Helps you keep the right sail shape. Keep your vang off. Your main sheet does all your leash control. Tacking. Roll tacking takes a number of things done right to have a good tack. How fast you turn. Timing of the roll, how much you roll, the flattening, the exit angle, and the main trim, all are critical. Turn too fast, kill your speed. Turn too slow, and the tack will take forever. Tacking tips. Step 1. Trim main in a little to keep the boat flat. This helps the boat turn up. Step 2, head up, but don't turn too quickly, you don't want to stall the boat out. Step 3, roll the boat when you get head to wind, and not earlier. And don't leave the rail until you get the full roll. Step 4, get your hand switch done quickly. While switching your hands, you need to find a time to ease the main sheet out. This helps with the exit main trim. You don't want to finish your tack. Step 5. Flatten low on the boat, on your knees, not standing up. Try not to end up pinching out of the tack. Kill your speed. Try not to overturn, ending up on a reach. Avoid rolling your boat too hard and filling your boat up full of water. Remember, 1 gallon of water equals 8 pounds. And last, never heel your boat to windward after finishing a tack. That'll stall you out. Try to keep it smooth. Keeping it simple with a quick hand switch works sometimes too. It's nice to get those tacks done quick. Watch those early rolls. Always look over your shoulder before you tack. Notice the ease main trim coming out of the tack here. This helps you regain speed. Downwind. Going downwind is is all about good form. Getting your boom out to 90, getting a little boat heel in, getting your board up, keeping your weight forward are all critical. Keep the boat nice and stable. Try not to rock too much. Downwind tips. Get that boom all the way out to 90, but not past it. Once you get that sail out to 90 degrees, add some windward heel. Get that board up all the way out of the water. Keep one hand close to your boom vang. Be ready for those puffs. Vang on in the puffs, vang back off in the light spot. Keep that weight forward, but not too far. Sit down on the bench, put the bow down. Try to use your weight to turn the boat, rather than your rudder. Avoid sailing by the lee for long periods. That means heading down past dead downwind. Constantly keep an eye on your leech downwind. Keep that leech open, but don't let it taco. Careful about over-trimming your sail. Watch your sail for the slightest bit of luffing. Sail looks good, heel looks good, board could come up further out of the water. Next up, jibing. Start your jibe with the lee board down. This helps your boat track through the jibe, keeps it from twisting. Start off the jibe by using your weight to help the turn. Get some windward heel in to help that boat carve down. Bring that mane in a couple feet to help that boom get across earlier. While carving the boat down, look up at your leech, watch for the transition. Once you see that top batten transition, it's time for three good pulls out of the block. Quickly get across the boat, get that hand switch in, flatten low in the boat, on your knee, and get that sail back out to 90. Once you got your sail out to 90, add some heel, get your lee board up if you're on starboard tack. This is a great jibe here. Nice body weight to help the turn, and three good pulls out of the block to help the boom across. Not much rudder was used, and the jibe got done quickly. Careful about having your vang too eased and tacoing. Mark roundings. Good weather mark roundings take windward heel and mane eased out to help the turn. You want to carve that boat down, easing mane and using your body weight. The less rudder, the better. The leeward mark rounding. Probably the most important mark rounding in the race. Nail the rounding and you'll probably finish well in the race, passing boats. Have a bad rounding and expect to lose boats. Use your body weight and mane trim to help the boat turn. Heeling the boat to leeward and trimming the mane in both help minimize rudder usage. When you got the space, get those wide and tight turns in. Careful about pinching up after the mark rounding. You're going to want to sail fast for an extended period. Try to stay on the inside and round single file. You don't want to get pinwheeled. Plan well ahead of the three bone length circle so you don't end up on the outside. Great form here using body weight and sail trim. And a nice exit.